नमस्ते, माय नेम इज़ JVN ऋषि गौतम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म। टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ द चैलेंज ऑफ सिटीज़न जर्नलिज्म। अ डिकेड अगो द टर्म सिटीज़न जर्नलिज्म वाज नियरली एज मेन स्ट्रीम एज द मेन स्ट्रीम न्यूज़ इटसेल्फ। Anyone with access to a computer could contribute to the news, raising the question of the role of professional journalism. Today, with the rise of social media and the constant flow of digital information, what does citizen journalism mean? In July 2016, elementary school worker Philando Castiles shooting death by a Minnesota police officer captivated the United States. His girlfriend Diamond Reynolds had pulled out her cell phone at the time of Castiles' death. Filming the scene and live blogging it on Facebook. While there were aspects of his death that remained continuous, much of what happened was available for the world to see. Reynolds probably didn't consider herself a citizen journalist at the time, but she and so many others around the globe are using their cell phones to record daily events and broadcast them across social media. Today is going where mainstream journalists can't go, where authorities aren't, and they are providing information that isn't available anywhere else. Citizen journalists are changing the news media landscape of today. Only many wouldn't call themselves as much. Dr. Saqib Riaz, an associate professor of mass communication at Allama Iqbal Open University in Islamabad, Pakistan, says the title has changed, but the phenomenon is still the same. Now, social media has taken the job of citizen journalism, he says. Basically, social media is an advanced form of citizen journalism that has made it possible for each and every person to be a citizen journalist. Upload still and moving images, photographs, videos, audios, comments and many other things. Less than a decade ago, social media was just starting to find its footing. When smartphone technology exploded around the world in 2013, recording daily events and uploading content via social media became commonplace, and that threatened and continues to threaten how professional journalists do their jobs, as it is physically impossible for journalists to be present at every event. Social movement or crime scene in the world, people rely heavily on this new form of citizen journalism. When things happen or there's breaking news, we expect citizens to be there and to be the first ones on the scene, says Stuart Allan, professor and head of the School of Journalism, Media and Culture Studies at Cardiff University. But Alan says that while experts may call the phenomenon citizen journalism, not all citizens may be aware that they are taking part in creating the news. There are plenty of people who go to the scene, document it with a cell phone and upload it to social media, but don't consider themselves journalists, says Alan. And then there are some people who have a desk job during the day and at night will go to cover a local meeting at night now that their local paper doesn't exist. In the same way, citizen journalism functioned years ago as a way for little known news to get reported. The current social media documentation of events offers a way for people to get news about anything and everything. And the mainstream media, while it has mixed feelings about the role of social media in capturing the news, relies heavily on this information. Many untold and unreported news stories appear every day on social media, and traditional media picks them up and publishes or broadcasts them, says Dr. Riaz. If you see something happening before you, you can simply record it on your phone and share it on social media. This is simple philosophy and strength of today's citizen journalism. Social media can also go where mainstream media won't go due to safety concerns. Citizen journalists have been vital to getting news from Syria since its 7 years long civil war began. Most mainstream media outlets in the West have been unwilling to send journalists to Yemen to report on the ongoing crisis due to fears for their safety, and in the tribal areas of Pakistan, where the country's 2,000-kilometer border with Afghanistan has become a war zone in the last two decades, social media has played an essential role in the war against terrorism. Thank you.